Hi everybody, this is a quick review of our first Unit 5 lesson 5.01 workshop Cultural Viewpoints and Experience. The I can statements for today are explain how cultural viewpoints and experiences are reflected in literature to prepare me for reading the reading material in Unit 5. Examine how culture or history shapes or influences literature so I can better understand the Unit 5 reading material. And finally, I'll know I got it if I participate in today's class and name at least 5 cultural groups that I am a part of. Here's our power standard for Unit 5. Analyze a particular point of view or cultural experience reflected in a work of literature from outside the United States, drawing on a wide reading of world literature. So our agenda today was cultural impact, setting, and then homework. And this is the first question we asked ourselves. So how do you define culture? So why don't you pause the video for a few seconds and think to yourself, how do I define culture? What is culture and how do I define it? All right, did you define it? Perfect. All right, let's go to the dictionary definition of culture. How close did you come? It says right here that definition of culture, the customary beliefs, social forms, and material traits of a racial, religious, or social group. Also, the characteristic features of everyday existence, such as diversions or a way of life shared by a people in a place or time. So after we had defined culture, we moved on to cultural impact in literature. So the beliefs and customs of a particular group of people constitute that group culture, right? So we agreed on that. The culture has a strong effect on literature. By reading books from other cultures, you can develop a better understanding of the world and of that culture you're reading about. So we find out that an author's culture influences their writing. And then we took an example of different books that were world literature books. So we looked at Chinua Achebe's Things Fall Apart, which I believe takes place in South Africa or in an African nation. Gabriel Garcia Marquez takes place in Central America. We'll be reading The Alchemist in our next unit, so that takes place in the Middle East. Life of Pi is based on a story from India, and Kite Runner takes place in Afghanistan. So these are just various examples of what world literature and cultures that you may not be familiar with that you can learn about. All right, then after that, we asked ourselves the question, what kind of cultures do we have in the United States and how many can we list and what cultures are you a part of? So pause the video and try to write down 5 cultures that you are a part of. For example, are you a person of color? If you're a person of color, you're part of that culture. For example, are you black? Then you're a part of a black culture. What about religion? Are you a Christian? Are you a Muslim, Hindu? Whatever religion you are, then you're part of that culture. Do you game? You're part of that culture. Do you do Minecraft? Minecraft has its own culture. Let's say, are you a big Star Wars fan? Star Wars fandom has its own culture and so on. So how many can you name? Again, pause your video and see if you can come up with 5. Now here's an example. So I'm going to ask you to pause and read the example. And then when you're done, push play again. All right, welcome back. All right, application time. So think about these questions. You can compare it to the example we had with Akinye, or you can think about other books that you've read, or even movies that you read that showed a different culture than what you're part of. Compare the literary work to your life. Have you had similar feelings or experiences? Can you connect the events or images in the literary work to anything you have seen or heard about or read about elsewhere? And then the final question, how do these similarities and differences affect your understanding of the literary work and the culture that produced it? So once you've done with that, then we went through language described setting. So pause to read this, or wait a second, I'll read the setting definition. Setting is a literary term for time, place, physical details, and circumstances in which the action of the narrative occurs. All right, so the language can describe the setting, correct? and that will give us an insight into the author's culture. Here's another setting example. You can pause to read this and then answer the question, what is the time and place of this story? What language told you that? Like underline or highlight which ones you think, which language told you that or which words told you that. All right, then here is the answer for the setting example. Take a look at that, pause to read it, please. And then we were done. So we reviewed how I explained how cultural viewpoints and experiences are reflected in literature, prepare me for the reading material in Unit 5. And I examined how culture or history shapes and influences literature, so I better understand the Unit 5 reading material. And the homework after that lesson was to read The Harvest by Tomas Rivera for the next lesson. And then we said goodbye. So if you have any questions about this after you view the video, contact myself, Ms. Miller, Ms. Cohen, Ms. Kazmarek, or me, and we'll help you out. Thank you very much, everyone.